Finally arrived. I've had a chance to try them out a bit. Not bad. Typical $70 speakers. I actually did somewhat of a review on another channel. I'll leave a link in the description if you are interested in that. And a few problems I found with them. But the reason I bought them is I wanted them for the tweeters. The air tweeters, anyway. My thick film tweeters, and the front cover here is all rubber, which is nice. Basically, when you buy these, you're basically buying the tweeters. Just the rest is just the feller. The driver isn't much. I mean, the tweeter is nice. It's all metal on the back. But that's not what this video is about. This is a modification. I basically was playing around with a mid-range on my speakers that I just rebuilt, and I like it. So I figured I might as well. What my initial plan was to take these out, put a new one in there, and use them for whatever. And I was going to use these on these ones that I was working on now. Didn't turn out that way. I went ahead and made the crossovers for mid-range. It's been measured out and rolled properly, somewhat properly. 10 microfarad 50 volt cap, which works. They sound pretty good, and it's definitely more information in the music just with the small little driver there. So what I'm going to do with these, I've been started pulling them apart now. These rubber feet that were on the bottom are going to be going on the side, because I want to lay them on their side, because they basically are the same width as the speakers I have now upstairs. So if I put these on the side, they won't dance around, and it'll pretty much blend in with the other speakers and give you my mid-range and my ribbon tweeter. The only thing we really have to modify is to basically just cut the wire off the driver and add this, and the rest of the power resistor and the cap for the tweeter is still there. We'll use the existing. These are soldered direct to the clips on the back. There's no driver crossover for these. So what we're going to do is take them upstairs and just basically see which configuration we're going to put them in and what looks good. I also had an idea of maybe taking an X-Acto knife and a ruler and cutting it out to the laminate off, but leaving a black edge and painting the face gray or silver, the same color as the speakers upstairs. That way they look like they're part of the set. We might do that in the future, but right now let's just take it upstairs, check what configuration we're going to put it in, and add these and do a sound check. Alright, so this is the setup I came up with. It's either that way or that way, obviously. It looks somewhat normal that way, and I'm thinking of probably, like I said, cutting this out and peeling the laminate off. It is actually coming off around the driver anyway, and painting it the same color as this, so it sort of matches with the rest of the speaker. But that'll work. I've already marked it. We'll take it downstairs, glue the feet on, and go from there. Okay, now that we have the feet out of the way, they're on there pretty good. I'm going to take the drivers out and add our crossovers. I gotta be careful with these screws, because the box is actually so thin that they're stripping already just from removing them once, which I detailed in my video, or my small review. Trying to remember what I used to remove that. I think it was my screwdriver. It's right here. Now, I'm not going overboard with this. I'm just basically soldering the coil and the capacitor to the wire at the end of the terminal of the speaker. I could mount it somewhere, but there's not going to be much bass reflex. It's a mid speaker anyway, so. Yeah, see how the box is sticking to it? That's brutal. So if I wanted to peel this off, I could, and then paint it gray to match the other box. I think all we should have to do is just basically just cut the wire here. Oh wait, no, let's try unsoldering it. And then we'll solder this up. Okay. That wasn't on there very good. That's better. Put it through the hole. Leave it like that. It's not going to damage anything. What I would like to do also is stuff the box full of insulation right to the driver itself, because we really don't need that the box for like bass response. It's a mid-range. Usually mid-ranges are the basket of the speaker most of the times is sealed. Or it's sealed off from the rest of the speaker box anyway. Just going to quickly check this and make sure it works. Should have checked it before I put the screws in, but I have a good feeling.
getting started is the hardest thing in business. Fill out this form and the government's asking you questions, and then you go to the bank and the bank is asking you the same set of questions. Using a
works. All right, so I do the same to the other, and then we'll take it upstairs and try it out.
Yeah, so that's the high level overview.
Well, that's about it. So there wasn't much to really video. I mean, I reused the speakers. I might not paint the fronts, take the laminate off. I might leave it the way it is if I decide to revert back to the way they were. I just take the crossover out and I can use them as is. But what I'll do when I get around to it is I'll find some decent music that I can play, and we'll do a sound test when no one's home, obviously. Later, guys.